Okay, Tony and Rich here. We're all hooked up. We just picked up here at Affinity in Prescott, Arizona. I did the warranty work that was needed for the water heater and also put on a slow start, deal for my air conditioner. Hopefully it will work now with everything. So there it is. We have the 2021 Ford F250. The hitch looks good. There's no squat. Everything's real nice with it. Maybe 1 inch. And then we got it all dialed in. Weight distribution hitch. We're good to go there. We'll talk about that soon. And there it is. 28-foot Imagine 2800 bunkhouse. Also 21. So we got lots of new toys here that we're going to be careful going home. Got some weather moving in. So we're going to get out of here and head back to the valley. Next time we'll talk will be on the road. All right, Tony and Rich here once again. We are hooked up, as you can see behind us there. They charged me 1 hour of labor to install the slow start deal for the AC. And the warranty work, of course, was covered under warranty, which it should be. It should never have had to happen. Imagine the first time you take your camper out and the hot water is non-existent. I mean, it worked for 20 minutes. And after that, I shut it off. Go, hey, it works great. Don't need it till tomorrow morning. Next morning, I turned it up. No hot water. Couldn't do it from propane. Couldn't do it from electric. Nothing. So that was in June. It's now July 31st, and it's resolved. That's how long. About 6-7 weeks, because we faked it up in Prescott just by carrying water, like we were tent camping again, heating water on the stove. Anyway, we are cruising through back, weight distribution hitch is hooked up, feeling good. Either way, I keep this thing on the freeway at about 65. I'm not gonna rush it. This is a big camper, even though the truck's bigger. I've seen too damn many videos of one-ton F450s, F350s, rolled over on the side pulling trailers this size, or even goosenecks and fifth wheels, so. We're not gonna rush anything. We got one little downhill deal, it's about 10 miles. After that, it's pretty easy run to Phoenix. So, cruising through Prescott Valley. We'll get back to you as we get close to Sunset Point. Check in with you then. See ya, bye. All right, we are coming up to Sunset Point. Past the rest stop there, and then we go down into New River, which is 6% grade. Truck is running and pulling it very good. The camper's doing well, tows very well with this new hitch setup, professionally set up from Rick's Hitch. Shameless plug for them. And Rich's GoPro keeps shutting off because it's overheating. The other thing is, so getting on the on-ramp to get onto the freeway, to the I-17 from the Prescott Freeway, I forget what it is, 69. Get onto the interstate from the 69 highway. Anyway, so I gave a little gas to get up to freeway speed, and you look down, and this F-250 with the 7.3 Godzilla is over 80 miles an hour in a heartbeat. And you know, I got lots of pedal, and I'm just impressed with the power of this motor, more than I want to pull this camper at. Right now we're at 65 exactly. And cars are passing me, and it's fine, no issues at all. In fact, I like it though. But 65 is good enough. We're about, where are we at, 68? 65 to 70 is good enough on these roads. Going to California, I might bump it up to 75 because it's a flat road. You know, take the I-10 from Phoenix, or the I-8 to San Diego. It's pretty much flat road until you get toward the end where the mountains are coming into San Diego, so. Alright, so we're going to spin the camera around here and get some road shots here. I'll keep us in the loop here. Just like that.
Turn it around?
No, tighten it. That's good, that's good. Thing. All right, so now we're listening to Steve Miller Band. Sunset Point is a funny It's like on the top of the hill, and then we start to head back down. Or it's the, once you come up from Phoenix, you go up that 6% grade, and once you level off, you're right here at Sunset Point. Called that because it's a pretty awesome view off to the right, off to the west. All right, 73 miles an hour, gonna slow down here. So we start at 1%, or 6% grade in 1 mile. Speed transmission, we are in gear number 8. And no commercials. Sirius XM's Classic Rewind. Using a little engine braking here, I got it locked in. It's coming down fourth now anyway. So fourth gear, it's holding in at 56 miles an hour on a 6% downhill grade. Could go faster, don't need to go faster right now. Everything feels terrific. Some riding down there. That's a Bumblebee exit. There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the second way into Crown King, Arizona, which is a fun ride we've done a few times now. Confused me a lot, my voice was Steve Perry's. Yeah, all the time. Yeah. You know. Well said. Black Canyon City's 5 miles away, New River 16, some of the finest pies you'll ever find. But we are not stopping for pie. Okay, so here we are cruising again. We were just passing Black Canyon City, heading to New River. And all is well, towing good. We'll get back to you in a little bit, maybe when we get to the house or a little before. But the hilly part of this adventure is pretty well done. Trailer felt great, no issues. I averaged 57, 58 to 60 coming down that hill. And the motor was holding back. It liked to be in fourth gear or fifth gear, trying to hold it down into the 50s. So far, so good. Feels good. Very impressed with this F-250, the way she pulls. 28-foot bunkhouse, which is empty, but there's still things in it because, you know, you add more stuff into it. So the tongue weight, I'm guessing, is somewhere around 650 now, 670. And the entire thing is probably about 7,300 pounds right now. We got no water in it or anything, but somewhere in there. Okay, that's it for now. Tony signing off. Stacy's mom has got it going on. She's all I want, and I've waited for so long. Stacy, can't you see? You're just not good for me. I know it might be wrong, but I'm in love with Stacy's mom. Towards the house here, another mile or two. All in all, the truck ran great. Really proud of this truck. It just feels good. The camper feels like it's mated for it. Like the 10-speed transmission is mated to this 7.3 Godzilla motor. It feels a good combination. 3/4-ton truck and this big camper back here just feels right, which is all you can ask for. You know, it's all you can ask for. Just it not much sway at all, nothing going on, but hey. The rails, man. I'm going off the rails on a crazy train. Anyway, so yeah, just about home. I'll give it one quick walk around when we get home and finish this thing up. In that case, I already dropped off Rich. It's just me and the Oz. Me and the Oz, man. Okay, home sweet home, Chandler, Arizona. Brought her back all the way down from wonderful Prescott, Arizona. Got the Grand Imagine, 2,800 bunkhouse, and the F-250, both 21s, looks good. Again, weight distribution hitch did a great job. I'm going to get a video on that here real quick, and you'll see that coming up pretty soon. But hats off to Ford and Grand Design, at least so far so good. The Ford really is just a wonderful truck for pulling. She is a workhorse and loves every minute of it. So that's it for now. That's it for now. Tony's from Tony's Trucks, Campers, and Outdoors Channel. Hope you're having a fabulous day. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.